Alright, I'm back with you again. I'm currently rendering the first part of this video about handbrake comparisons, and you can see it's 13% now. The slowest part of any, I think, of any video production is rendering. I think that has a lot to do with the computer speed. This is a very slow computer. It's running at less than 2 gigabytes. I get gigabytes and gigahertz all confused all the time, but it's running less than 2 gigahertz speed on the CPU. So I'm not gonna sit here and force you to watch this all. I'll bring you back as soon as it starts to upload, and we'll see how long it takes to upload. So be right back. Alright, we got the video rendered. Finish that. We'll go out of this. And I should find it in YouTube uploads. I believe it should be Handbrake 1, I think is the name of it. Yep, there it is. Handbrake 1. And we'll see what the properties of it is. It's a 3-minute video, basically, so. MP4, it is 22.2 megabytes. Now, what we'll do real quick is run that through Handbrake. I think it's already started, yep. Let's do the source here is a file. Find Handbrake 1. Too far. There it is. Open that. That changes the destination file automatically, which I like. And basically, the only thing you do is press start and let it work, which is what I do. And it's preparing to encode. It's started now. It's running pretty quick. I want to give you an idea how long this takes. This, like I said, this is a 3-minute video. It's 22 megabytes. So you can see the added time it takes to run through Handbrake. Decide for yourself if it's worth it as far as uploading to YouTube is concerned, because we're going to do that too. And like I say, it doesn't take very long. I don't know what else to say. There's a lot of options on Handbrake that I have not explored. This is just the default. I don't know if there's anything I could choose to make it better, worse, or anything like that. I really don't know enough about the program. I just basically downloaded it and I'm using it as is. So a lot of options there to choose from. A lot of customization, I guess, is what I'm saying. I did choose the web optimized, so I checked that. That's the only thing I really checked as far as making changes to the default. I figured that has to be good. So, and we're at 89%, 90, 91, 2. Like I say, it runs pretty quick. And once this is done, we can take and upload it to YouTube and just get an idea of it's finished now. So we'll get out of that, go to YouTube, and YouTube runs, or this runs a little slow when Movie Studio is up. I've got a couple of videos to watch. Buzz, he uploaded one, it looks like, and Terry's got one, another welding video, it looks like. Select the YouTube uploads. When I say Handbrake 1. There it is. So you have Handbrake 1, and this is the one that come out of Handbrake. Is it puts, like Lloyd said, it says puts a -1 behind it, and it's also an M4V file, so it should be easy to spot. So we'll open that. And in. I'm not gonna do anything about the description at all. I just want to see how long it takes to upload, basically, and we'll go from there. It's going pretty quick. One of the things I've noticed about upload is usually YouTube will give you a little message over here. It says you need to encode your, there it is right there. Okay, may have audio video sync issues. Okay, that's a little different one. That's a quality thing, so I'm not gonna worry about that. Usually there's one that says you need to encode it in a streamable format and this and that and everything. I've noticed it doesn't do that with this. It hasn't done it so far, so like I said, it 3 minutes remaining. I'm not gonna make it, let's sit here and wait for that. We'll come back and show you when it's done, how long it took and stuff like that. So, well, it'd be kind of hard to do though, won't it? I guess we'll go ahead and, 3 minutes is not very long. We'll go ahead and finish it off and see how long it does take. But, like again, this is a 3 minute video. It's a short video. And at some time, as soon as I'm not going to make a special one just for it, but I want to try a longer video and see what that kind of time it takes. This one's going pretty quick. I mean, it's faster than the ones that I usually do. I would have said probably closer to 5 minutes on this one when the time remaining comes up. Usually just my experience. So anyway, now we're down to 2 minutes. I like the program. It's not bad. It like I say, it's quick. Doesn't take long to run it through the compression. And you know, I'm always for anything that makes things quicker. Because usually when I'm doing this, I don't, unless it's a really, really long video, I don't sit here and wait, or I sit here and wait for it. If it's a long one, I will put the computer down and go do other stuff. But if it's, you know, a matter of 5 minutes or less, you know, I try to go ahead and wait for it. I might view another website or something like that while it's uploading. But I generally don't go away and do anything else while it's doing it. So we're down to a minute now, so went pretty quick. There's a tag. I went ahead and put that in there. I'll add the description after I get this done. We'll find out how long it took. So we're 94% now. So this must be a pretty good, as far as YouTube's concerned, compression and stuff like that, because all right, it's on processing now. It's done uploading. So it has uploaded. That's how long it took. So the publishing, or the processing, usually it doesn't take too long. But well, there it goes, pretty quick too. That's even actually quicker, I believe. So I like that. When it gets to 95%, seems like it hangs up there. Sometimes you get the message where it says it's queuing your video because it's taking too long or something like that. I haven't got that message either, so. This is boring, isn't it? Like watching paint dry. Oh well. I want to get through the whole thing and then I can go on and add the description and everyone can let you guys go on about your business. But anyway, when I do this one, I'll add some comments about it and what I thought about it and things like that. So far it looks pretty positive to me anyway. There you go, it's done now. Even though it says it's processing 95%, it does have the thumbnail up there, so usually when that's done, it can be watched. I'm not going to publish it yet, so I think it'll stay at 95% until I probably publish it. So we'll call that done, and then like I say, I'll go ahead and finish this off and give you my thoughts on it and things like that. So I'll be back in a second. I'm back with you again, YouTube. I want to wrap this up real quick. I think it's my opinion is it's on longer videos it would be worth it to do this. Shorter videos, I'm not really sure. Yes, it's quicker. I don't know if it's worth the time and trouble to run it through Handbrake on a short video. This was a 3-minute video that I did. I would have to say it's a toss-up on whether it's going to be shorter to upload for total time. From rendering to completion of upload, I would say the time is really kind of close on a short video. Longer videos definitely is worth it on running through Handbrake, because the time it takes to run it through that is, like I say, a fraction of the rendering time. And I would say that the upload time would probably be greatly reduced on longer or larger, I should say, videos. Some of you guys may not be saving your videos in MP4 format. That has a lot to do with how quickly it uploads and stuff like that. The size of the video itself, when you go into YouTube upload and start uploading, the size of that video has a lot to do with it. I've come from the days of putting in large videos and sitting here for hours and hours and hours while it uploads. So the way I do mine is I put it in a 360 by 2, I can't remember what the total, or 320 by something, 260 maybe. But it's a wide format, but it's a small wide format. And the it's very compatible with the camera that I have, this Kodak Playful camera, and in the WVGA mode, and it works out really well. It's pretty quick, is what I'm trying to say. So some of you guys that don't use stuff like that, you use different formats and your videos are a lot longer, definitely would probably benefit from putting your video through Handbrake before uploading. So that's all I really wanted to say, and I want to get this uploaded. It's going to be a long one too, so we'll see how well this one works. So I'll try to put it in the description on how well it worked and stuff like that. So thanks for watching, and have a good day.